Our next guest at this time is the Bella Twins, Nikki and Brie.
Show the bumps,
right? Yes, let's see your bumps.
We on the bumps, showing bumps.
We are so pregnant. Brie's literally Yeah, I'm doing like a week and a half. I'm already dilating, so who knows? My water could break right now. I'm less than, I'm like 2.5 weeks
Wait, so close. So, how are you guys feeling so close to the due dates?
We're really tired, very uncomfortable. We're not sleeping good. So we're ready. We want these babies out.
Yes.
So ready.
I want to meet my son. Dying to meet him.
Well, it seems like you guys have really been enjoying this pregnancy up until now when you're not sleeping, but from, you know, being neighbors to Artem cooking, which looks delicious. How has it been going through this entire experience together?
You know, I have to say it's been really special. You know, Nicole and I both were so surprised when we got pregnant. We both weren't expecting it. And this whole journey, especially during the times that we're going through right now, it's made it really fun, but also like, when you say positive,
yeah,
it's just been nice.
It has, and like, you know, for me, this is my first time in something that I've always dreamed of, to be a mom and to be pregnant, have this feeling. And when COVID hit, it was so tough because Artem can't go to the doctor's appointments with me, but I've been so fortunate because Brie can.
We go together.
Because she's pregnant, so we go together, and I've just been so fortunate to have Brie during this time. One, there's no one drinking around me that it helps because I miss my wine. So I have my sober partner, right, which has been nice. But she's just been my like doctor next door, which has just been so great.
Yeah.
That's amazing. And ladies, on top of your podcast, reality show, YouTube channel, wine brand, clothing brand, you also wrote a book together recently, which is just, I mean, how many things? It's amazing. How rewarding a process was that? And were there any challenging aspects to co-writing a book together?
Oh, yes. You know, it was a long process. It took us 2.5 years because we are so busy. I was literally telling her today, I'm like, I'm almost going to be delivering a baby and we go nuts. Every day we're doing something.
Nonstop. We don't go nuts. We go nonstop.
So when we came to write the book, it took us a little long, but it was really hard for us because we've never really opened up about our childhood. So we were really nervous to and tell stories we haven't told anyone. And so that took a lot of courage, but it felt really good to get it out because we knew our stories, like we've seen on the reality show, will help people. And that was our goal.
And Brie and I, we've always been open books, like Brie has said. And like, I didn't think we could dig deeper into our closets, but we did. And we have everything out there. And, you know, especially WWE Universe knows, we have the most intimate, incredible fan base called the Bella Army. And that was part of writing this, that even though we had such tough moments, especially for me, because I shared stories that I didn't even tell my mom yet, I just knew that my Bella Army needed people, it needed someone to relate to and truly show them that they could be a hero of their own story, that we don't have to live this life of being victims of what's happened to us, whether it's something tragic or whatever has caused us pain, but that we could overcome it and survive. And that's what was really important to Brie and I when we wrote this memoir. It wasn't just about like, hey, look at all our accomplishments. It was like, how can we truly help people change their lives for the better?
Absolutely. Well, you just mentioned the Bella Army. Ryan mentioned your YouTube channel. So I want to give you a big congratulations that you guys are almost at 3 million subscribers. That's insane.
Yes.
So how do you guys celebrate?
So we made a fun video already. So once we hit 3 million, we're going to put it up where a bunch of people surprised us. It was like a Zoom party.
A Zoom party, you know, because we're in quarantine and all.
So,
but we had a lot of fun surprise guests. So the minute we hit 3 million, we're going to drop it.
Yeah.
And then once the babies are out and we all could just, you know, be out and party again without masks, we will throw a huge party.
That's right.
I need Dom P back in my life.
Yes. Why?
Ladies, we're celebrating 5 years of the Women's Evolution here today. But of course, you two were holding it down here long before that name ever existed. As we like reflect on the past now, especially today, but throughout this entire week, how proud are you two of the fact that you were at the head of this division during such an important time in its history?
Oh my gosh. You know, We were actually talking about it yesterday. I can't believe it's been 5 years, but it was such an amazing time because we saw the locker room team so many different times. We saw women from the past wanting, you know, change. And we just saw how many women, you know, really put in their blood, sweat, and tears to pave this road. And the fact that Nicole and I got to be at the forefront of it, it gives me goosebumps. It made us channel every woman that we saw work hard. Right. And it was incredible.
Yeah, it's, you know, such an honor because it almost, you feel like in this moment, it's kind of funny being pregnant and about to be a mom, but I feel like a proud mom because when you put your own blood, sweat, and tears into something and you see this vision of wanting equality and change and knowing that women deserve better because the women around you worked so hard and you saw their talent, you saw what the fans wanted. And so we've been a part of that locker room till it happened. We were part of that locker room for 13 years. So we saw the changes, but we saw the hard work of every generation, every era of women wanting that change. And when it came to that night in Atlanta, when we truly put our foot down, all of us women coming together and making that change, it was like, it gave me the feeling of maybe what it felt like for women who could vote. And I know that's such a crazy analogy, but that's how it felt for us female wrestlers, right, for us female WWE superstars. And so to see it now, what women have continued to do 5 years after the fact is just, it's amazing. And it makes me just proud mama bear over here and also honored to be at the forefront of it.
Yeah. You guys talk about being in the locker room during that time, but you were also in the ring during that iconic moment 5 years ago when Sasha, Becky, and Charlotte debuted. You guys were really at the top of the division at that time. So what was it like having this new wave of talent enter the fray in that way and really catapult the Evolution into existence?
I mean, I got to steal the Rock's line. It was electrifying being out there. It was, I'll never forget that crowd. And it was incredible. And you know, for me, that promo Stephanie cut on us, on Team Bella, and me being the Divas Champion, it was hard not to take it personal. And I remember I did. But that's the storylines that are so incredible at WWE when you can bring something personal into it and you have those emotions. You felt Stephanie's passion as she delivered it. You felt what we are feeling. And then when the other women came out, Becky and Charlotte and Sasha, and it was just like, I knew in that moment they picked the right group of girls to move this train forward. And I was like, we're going to do it. We're going to have change.
And they picked the right villains.
You
know, I always feel like the Bella name, you know, especially because Total Divas at that time was on fire. And just with the Bella twins, everyone, there was something about you love to hate us. And you,
the men we were dating.
Everything. That it couldn't have been more perfect timing, just all around.
Well, and with the fans too, because right before that, they started the hashtag Give Divas a Chance. And it was just like, with that and the fans being so with it of wanting more too, like, I mean, timing truly is everything. That saying is so right. And timing was everything for all of us.